along, guys. Matt with MotoWorks here, and I have a nice quick video for you. I'm going to show you guys how to replace the turn signals as well as the headlight bulb on a BMW G310R. Now, some of you have had questions for me when it comes to certain dimensions. I had one guy asking me the dimensions of an air filter, and I'll put my Instagram up here on the screen, as well as my Facebook. For questions like that, I can answer those questions. I'm not gonna make an entire video going over things like that, but I'll certainly answer those questions, and these are the places that you can reach me. Now that we have that out of the way, let's go into turn signal replacement on this G310R. The tools we're gonna use, believe it or not, are supplied by BMW. We just need the 10 millimeter wrench that they have, and the 5 millimeter Allen wrench that they have. Now, myself, I like to wear gloves because when we're dealing with the headlight, you don't want to get your oily fingers on the headlight bulb, because what can happen is that can cause the bulb to have early failure. So a pair of gloves is good for this job. If all you're doing is replacing the turn signals, the gloves probably really aren't needed. But that's just something before we get started. All right, so to get started, I'm gonna show you the headlight replacement first. There's only two bolts that you have to remove. And it's these two bolts right here, one on the left side, one on the right side. All right, so all we have to do is remove those. Again, we're just gonna use the tools included. Alrighty guys, so the screw we're removing is this bolt here with the long collar. Alright, if something else other than this comes out, then you probably removed the wrong bolt, but these are the two screws that you should be removing, okay? Alright, so it's just those two screws, guys, and now all we have to do is push down on the top here. There's two clips under here. We just want to push down gently, and that'll just swing forward, and then we'll have access to the headlight bulb as well as the turn signals now. There are two bolts in the bottom that are gonna keep this supported. So all we have to do to replace the headlight bulb is just come in and remove the plug. You just pull straight out on that. We'll then take off this boot, noting where the top of the boot is, so we can put it back the same way we took it apart. Just pull that boot off. And then there's only a spring clip here. And to release this spring clip, you just push down. That releases the tension on that clip, and then just hold on to it when it goes up because it is under tension. And then just pull out on the headlight. And that's how you remove the bulb. Again, you want to be careful not to get your fingers on the actual bulb glass itself. If you have gloves on, that's all right if you accidentally touch it. If you do happen to touch it with your fingers, alcohol wipes work good to clean them off, but you want to make sure that you don't have any residue on that headlight when you're replacing it. All right, so we're going to put this one in. Again, notice there's three tangs here. We want to line those up inside that housing when we put that back in, and you'll know when you have that in. That'll just kind of fall in there and you won't be able to rotate it. The third prong on the back of the plug will stick up, and then we'll just put this spring back over. It'll push down on the back of the headlight bulb, and then we'll clip that back into place. Again, remember, this goes up towards the top. Then we just plug that back in. Pretty straightforward. Just line those connections up, push in on the headlight, and then before we put this all back together, we want to make sure that the headlight works. So we'll just turn the key on, low beam, high beam. Alrighty guys, let's go over the process in which to replace a turn signal on this bike. All right, for this, we're gonna use, again, the supplied tools. the 10 millimeter wrench, 5 millimeter Allen, and we're also going to be using a pair of diagonal cutters because we have to cut this zip tie off. So we will need a zip tie to replace this one. But again, it's pretty easy, and we could use the tools that BMW supplied with the bike. So to remove it, we're just going to take this turn signal bolt, loosen that lefty-loosey. There's a nut on the inside there. We're gonna take our wrench, hold on to that. These aren't super tight, so this will work just fine. All right, now there is a washer here, so you wanna be careful when we're taking this out that you don't lose that washer. It might stick in there, so you might be safe, but if it doesn't, just put a hand on it. All right, so there is a washer. There's a nut. There's the bolt. Okay, all right, now before we take the turn signal off, we wanna first make sure that we unplug it. Again, these plugs are simply just push down, pull out, those plugs come undone. Now to get this all to slide through the housing, we're first gonna cut this zip tie. All right, and that'll give us access there. Now, the only way this turn signal is gonna come out is it's slotted in there. So we first have to turn the turn signal clockwise down, pull out a little bit on it, and then that'll slot out of its housing. As you can see, it is slotted, and then there's also a position here for that. One thing to point out on these turn signals, they are directional right and left. They have what's called a water drain hole. So this one is for the left side of the bike as you're seated on it, because the drain hole's on the bottom. All right, so I don't know how the new turn signals are gonna come, but I imagine it's just gonna be a turn signal like this, so you need to pull some old hardware off. And one of those being this little brass bushing here that rests inside this housing and keeps that bolt from crushing the plastic. So make sure that if it doesn't come with your new turn signal, you have it from your old turn signal. Okay, and then the way it goes is this bolt goes through the turn signal, through the plastics, and then it goes washer, then nut on the backside. Alrighty, so just something I wanted to point out to you guys before we go and put this back together. What we have to do to reinstall the turn signal is we wanna fish this wire through the turn signal mounting hole there. And then we'll just, again, put that in there and we'll go clockwise. Just make that hand tight. That's good. First, we'll plug in turn signal, and then we'll just take the excess wire there, zip tie that back together. You know, you don't have to go crazy. It's not holding it or supporting it. It's just keeping it nice and neat. Snip the zip tie. All right, and we already have our headlight and everything plugged in. Make sure everything's plugged in and no wires are gonna pinch as you put this cover back up. Put that back up again. Now we wanna be gentle and push down and latch that back in. That'll sit in there nicely. You won't be able to move it out of the way. Now all that's left to do is just put the two bolts back in that you took out before. We'll make sure it works. Both sides. Headlight works. Job well done. Put the tools back in the toolkit. And you're good to go. All right, guys, so it's pretty straightforward for the turn signals as well as the headlight. BMW, again, supplies you with almost all the tools you need. If this video is helpful, give it a thumbs up. Leave a comment for any other videos you'd like to see me do on this or other motorcycles. Again, my name is Matt. This is MotoWorks. Thanks for checking out the video, guys.